Okay. Okay.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, everybody.
Welcome to episode 36 of the Legacy Knits podcast. I never looked this up beforehand, and I really should learn. We are a knitting, fiber-related, yarn dyeing podcast. And yeah, my name is Chelsea.
My name is Sue. I can't knit and do this at the same time. Yeah, I tried.
Oh, you tried. Okay. I'm the daughter.
I'm the mother.
And that's our thing. And my lighting's being really funky right now. I don't know why.
That's good. Oh, that's really good. But you're super close.
Oh.
You're like the big one this week. I'm keeping going further and further. Oh my gosh. Thank our people for joining us.
Yes. Thank you to all of our new viewers that are checking us out for the first time. If you like us, give us a thumbs up or subscribe. And if you don't, that's cool too. And thank you to all of our returning viewers. We love you so much. And yeah, thank you.
You're all the best.
You're all the best. We love you.
We have the best viewers.
We do.
We do. Between this and Periscope, I have the best viewers. Periscope, I have the best.
Yeah. Viewers. It's okay.
Minus the lurkers.
What's that?
Minus the lurkers.
I have no patience for that at all.
I know. I've gotten better.
Yeah.
Anyways,
so it is Sunday, October 9th. And we have a perfect fall day. You have a rainy fall day.
We have a rainy, rainy day. I think this is the effects of Matthew. The hurricane, I'm pretty sure, which is nothing. It's just rain, and it's a beautiful soft rain. I wish I was going to be in all day sitting by just a low crackling fire, not a huge one because we'd be too hot.
Yeah. Oh, that sounds so good.
I know, with some yummy like football food and knitting. Oh, that sounds like heaven. It's not going to happen today. It's okay. I'm going to a baby christening, which I love baptisms. I love them. They're my favorite, and I'm excited about it.
I can't say that I've been to one recently, or like at all, maybe.
I feel like you haven't been to one. Maybe you might be right at all.
I don't think I have.
I love them. They're second best to weddings for me.
Really?
Actually, sometimes they're even better than weddings. It depends.
That's so cool. I'll have to make my find my way to one.
Find someone that's having a baby and get super close to them and get to the christening.
I'm going to stalk the church.
I know. Oh my God. Is there a christening today? I'd like to come. Oh my gosh. We're so off topic already.
Oh, that's okay. So yeah, we just wanted to check in and show you guys some knitting, and yeah, we have some fun shop news, but we'll do that at the end.
At the end, super exciting shop news, and a quick thank you to everybody that bought our Elf update and sweater weather update. Elf is probably gone now because for this year, Elf is gone. Sweater weather is, I was asked on Periscope, I think, will that be part of our permanent line? And yes, absolutely, because I think it's our favorite.
It is. It's my favorite, definitely.
Yeah, and it lends to so many things.
Yeah.
So yeah, thank you, thank you, thank you again. Oh, there aren't enough thank yous.
Yeah, you guys are awesome. And
I know. Kind of blows my mind.
Yeah.
Every time it blows my mind.
Yeah. It's great. Like you said, there are no words to
describe. There are no words. And there are so many fantastic dyers out there right now that it's humbling to think that people are buying our yarn. So thank you. Okay.
What are you drinking?
Oh my gosh. Oh, well, it's super boring, but it's in the best glass. I think I already showed this.
It's so cute.
I love, you know, my love for witch's feet. The design element in Witch's Feet as an artist, I love it.
It's whimsical.
It's whimsical. That's it.
Your favorite word.
My favorite word, my form of art. Let's just say it. I had wanted to be a cartoonist. When I went to art school, that was my goal, was to become a cartoonist. And it quickly went aside because there was other things I enjoyed more. But it combines with, anyways, enough of that. Water is the answer to your question.
Water, but in a cool glass.
in a cool glass you have. Do you have that turbo root beer coffee?
No. And actually, I haven't talked to you about this yet. So the place that I work, this is going to be a quick little aside. Place that I work has a wellness coach, like a life and wellness coach. And I was telling mom, my energy levels have been very low. So I went to him and I was like, what can I do? Like, I feel like I do a lot of really good things. Like I eat well, I sleep well, I exercise. And so when we had our first meeting, he said, how much coffee do you drink? And I said, oh, you're not going to like the answer to that question. And so I told him the amount and he was like, okay, well, so here's my first idea. We need to wean you off of that coffee because it's masking your exhaustion. So I don't know where your natural energy levels are at. So this week, tomorrow starts weaning off of coffee.
I'm so glad I don't have to be around. Well, I do have to be around you next week.
At least, but I'm weaning off. So it's not altogether. And I honestly think I'm going to be okay. Because there's a reason I'm doing it. I'm not just
doing it.
You know what I mean? Like, and I want to get to the bottom of this. So I'm coveting this iced coffee because it's going to be probably one of my last ones for a little while. He said not forever, but just so that we can assess.
So we can cut all this out because it could be super boring. How much are you going to go down to?
None.
None tomorrow? That abrupt?
Oh, no. I'm sorry. So tomorrow, so I typically have 16 ounces in the morning and then 2 10-ounce cups in the afternoon.
You are your father's daughter.
It's way too much. And I honestly didn't even realize how much I was drinking until I said it out loud to him. And he was like, oh. So tomorrow I'm going to do my normal 16 ounces in the morning and then probably a half a cup in the afternoon. Because I think I can manage it. That second cup in the afternoon is always like do I need it? No. Do I want it? Yes.
Yes. Yeah, I agree. I would start with the same amount and then go and then wean off of that. Wow. Let's hope you're done by Thursday when I see you.
I'll try really hard.
Okay. It's okay. Oh my gosh. Well, that is interesting. And I wouldn't have thought of that. And he's 100% right.
He's like, you don't really know how tired, like you're probably even more tired than you think you are because you've just been masking it with coffee all this time. And he was wonderful too. He was like, some people cannot do this. Like, I'm not saying you have to do it, but I think if you have the ability to do it, it would be a good idea. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to do it.
You can do it. You can so do it. That's your whole mindset.
Yeah. But yeah, so iced coffee is what I'm drinking the long way around.
We really got to learn to be more direct with our answers. Oh my gosh. What'd you work on this week? What you're wearing?
I'm wearing the windswept shawl by a homespun house, Molly, who we love so much. It's one of my favorite shawls I've ever knit. It's one of my favorite shawls to wear. I wear it a lot. It's big. It's a size.
It's done. If you ever have the desire to knit anything for me, that would be it.
That's the one. Okay, that's good to know.
Not that you have to by any means, but oh my gosh, I love that knit.
It's gorgeous. And there's something about, like, I was looking at the Mara shawl by Madeline Tosh. And it's not like this, like it's not similar, but well, it's similar, but it's not the same. So I like having a thick border. Like I love shawls where it's like the body and then the lace or like, you know, whatever. But I really like the look of a solid shawl.
It's stunning. And I love the weight of it because it's not a flimsy shawl. It's a put it under your coat. It's like a scarf shawl, really, truly.
And it's knit out of DK weight yarn. I knit this in with Nice and Knit because it's one of my all-time favorites. And it has a picot bind-off, which I think is my favorite part of it. It was a bear to do. I love the result of a picot bind-off, but I hate doing it.
And let's just say it. I feel like that was one of your first knits.
It was definitely one of, definitely was.
It really was, because I remember thinking like, wow, you're really coming along as a knitter. It was new into your knitting career, which your year anniversary of knitting, has it already gone by?
Definitely. It was like January or February.
Oh, I thought it was this. Oh, you're right. Yeah. I was thinking it was this January. So think about it. You're on your 2-year almost anniversary of knitting, and your knitting abilities are right there with mine, and I've been doing it forever.
Oh,
quickly. No, definitely. I mean, your ability, you can knit anything.
Well, I think anybody can knit anything once you have the basic tools in your toolbox.
Absolutely. I totally agree with you. Once you can knit and purl, you can do anything. But you've also been the adventurous knitter. Like, some people aren't as adventurous, so it takes them longer. I think you dove in. You didn't go, well, I'll start with a scarf. And not that there's anything wrong with that, but you, like Justin, who is like, I want to knit socks, and he never knit a stitch in his life, and now he's a prolific sock knitter. So
yeah,
it speaks to your mindset, I think, of, like, I always, when I was working at the yarn shop, and I would hear people say, oh, no, you shouldn't do that yet. It's like, no, is that what you want to do? Do it right now. Do it right now. And that's just how my brain works. When I want to do something, I do it. So.
Yeah, I totally agree.
Yeah. Yeah.
That, like, everybody has a different pace and a different way of doing it. But, like, for us, that's, we definitely are very similar in that.
Yeah. We're go big or go home.
Yeah.
I'm finding that out more and more about myself. It's kind of frightening.
It's a cool quality to have.
Ooh, I don't know. I hope so. I'm not sure.
I love it.
I think it borderlines with obsession. Go big or go home, obsession.
You know, there are worse things in the world to be obsessed.
Absolutely. I agree.
So yeah, that's what I'm wearing. That's my knitwear. Although we were just out at Oakledge Park walking Romo around, and it was so cold, and I had no knitwear on.
It really was that cold.
It was freezing, but it's because of, there was such a strong breeze coming off the water and there was no sun. Like, it was freezing.
Yeah.
And I had no knitwear on. I was like, what is
Again, it's the weekend, so I want to be in Vermont.
I know.
I need a weekend home in Vermont. That's what I need.
You have a weekend pull-out couch.
I do, but that's not the same.
I agree.
All right, we'll start looking at realistic. Nah. Don't I sound like we're independently? Let's just buy a home in Vermont for the weekend.
The weekends, for those weekends that we want to go up.
I know, that's not going to happen. But anyways, it does. I crave it on the weekends.
Yeah, there's nothing like it.
I know. I agree.
The leaves are unbelievable right now. We went up to Stowe yesterday. A friend of ours came up. One of Justin's groomsmen came up to spend the night, and the day and the night. And we went up to Stowe to the Alchemist Brewery. And the leaves right now are brilliant. Like, I thought I had seen foliage living in Connecticut, and it's a different echelon. Like, it's just.
Did you go through Smuggler's Notch?
I don't know.
It's the road.
No.
It's like kind of at the, I feel like you go to Stowe, you go up and up and up, and then it's the road. I'm going to say this totally wrong. I thought it was a road that can lead you into Canada, but it's the most beautiful road in the world. You're right there at Stowe. You're there. I'm pretty sure people that live in Vermont are like, Sue, you're in the totally wrong area. It's been a while. Stowe is one of my favorite places in the whole wide world.
Stunning. It's magical. And we have ski passes there for the season.
You are, when I was a skier, which was quite a while ago these days, but when we skied at Stowe, it was my favorite mountain. And I'm not one that would even know one mountain from the other. I'm not a huge skier. I don't know how I married into this skiing family. There was a lot of crying involved and almost divorce.
You were a good skier, though. I do remember that. Like, once, oh, I always thought.
I could hold my own because I started too late. If I had started younger, I think I would have been a fantastic skier, honestly, because I was really athletic. But when you're an adult, fear creeps in. And then I had you guys and I thought, you know, skiing's great, but if I break my leg, who is going to take care of these three kids? Not that Dad didn't do anything, but he worked. And who's going to drive them and who's going to get them? And that's what really shut me down. And the fear got even greater. Like, I can't get injured.
Ah.
And I didn't, if I loved it enough, I would have powered through. I didn't. Anyways, skiing at Stowe, I remember being at the top and taking it in and saying, this is the closest I probably ever will be to Switzerland. It has a very European flair to it. You are going to love it.
Can't wait. I hope we. So much snow we can bear.
Well, and you have skied there before when you were little, because you were with us when we were there.
Oh, yeah,
so you've been there. You were little. All three of you, I'm pretty sure, were there skiing.
I have never been so excited for wintertime before. Yeah.
I'm so glad you're starting skiing again, because you were a really good skier and a natural, and all of you together, you're going to have a ball.
No, we have a group of like, that I know of, 10 of our really close friends that have ski passes. And our friend that came up last night, it was Wah. Like friends with someone that also has a ski pass up here. So he's like, I'm going to be spending some time too. I was like,
ugh. Super cool. It's so fun. I wanted to love skiing. I tried so hard. I think it's hard when you're a mediocre skier. Like I could hold my own, and you're skiing with expert skiers. You're like, I know you can do this black diamond. It's not that bad.
But like, if when you are an intermediate skier, it's like you don't even like it's one thing to ask if you want to join, but I don't know. I always felt weird about people saying like you can do it. It's like sure, maybe, but I have no desire, and I would be very uncomfortable.
So, yeah, and I would rather stay on this really nice, like easy, beautiful slope. And yeah, okay, let's talk knitting.
Anyway,
we're the worst.
We're the worst. We'll do a little bit of editing. So I have a finished object.
So do I. You go first.
Okay. Mine is a hat. It was a hat that I was going to cast on. Sorry, my nose is so itchy. That I was going to cast on last episode, and I did, in fact, cast it on, and I did finish it because it is a chunky knit. It is the Snappy Hat by Picnic Knits. It's made out of chunky yarn. I used...
Oh, super cute.
Maple mousse fibers. My little Harry Potter bag. I love it.
She made me a Beatrix Potter one that's over there. I've got to organize my projects and get them back in bags.
I think I need to do the same thing, reassess.
Yeah, because I need to bring them all to Rhinebeck, so I need to get them organized.
So yes, I knit mine, and this is how much I have left. I have quite a bit. I'm thinking I might make like a cabled headband.
Yeah.
So I knit it out of Quince & Co. Ibis.
Ibis.
What is it?
I said Ibis, but I don't know.
I think that's what it is. And the Albaline colorway. Yeah, Albaline colorway. And so I have...
Abalone.
Is that what it is?
Is that a word, abalone?
Like a bologna sandwich?
Abalene. I have no clue.
Either way, now you have seen the spelling, so...
Beautiful color.
It's a very, like, pale... gentle pink, almost, or purple, almost gray.
Gray, yeah. You're going to live in that. You are going to live in that.
Sorry, my hair is wild and crazy right now. Okay. I almost, I feel like Lara from her last episode when she had all the stuff in her mouth.
Oh my gosh, it is the cutest.
So yeah, pretty well.
Gosh.
I'm trying to decide pom-pom or no pom-pom.
Either. I can see it both ways. It's gorgeous.
Thank you.
I want to be a hat wearer.
I love hats. Yeah. So
I love them. I just can't pull. I really can't pull them off. I tried and then I go, nope. In your dreams.
Wait, and I think he can wear them. I feel like you could wear them too.
I can't. Did you say Justin? Justin can definitely wear them.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Oh, sorry, Justin. I thought you left getting us our muffins.
Justin asked if we needed anything at the beginning of the episode because he's our producer. And Mom said she wanted a muffin. So she figured he was on his way down to Connecticut.
On his way. I'm waiting.
So that's my finished object.
Okay, my finished object. I'm so glad we got the podcast in before I left because I can show the baby sweater.
It is so beautiful. I saw your picture on Instagram.
Yeah, christening gift. Oh, I love being a knitter when it comes to babies. Mm-hmm. Because literally, I mean, I knew I was making this forever and I started it this week. It's ridiculous.
But they're quick knits.
It is a quick knit, but again, I underestimate because this is a 12 to 24 month.
Mm-hmm.
It's top down. It is the Frida cardigan. It is on Etsy. It is by, Kristen Hipsky.
Okay.
And I love it. I love it. I love it. It's Valley Yarn Superwash DK. It is the most yummy yarn. 3 balls. So it costs, I don't even know, like, probably $20 for this gorgeous handmade sweater.
If you were to buy a baby sweater like that in a retail store, you'd pay at least double.
At least. And It's super sweet, and she doesn't have a lot of knitters in her life that I know of. I could be wrong. So I feel like it's kind of special. I didn't have time to block it,
That doesn't.
but I feel like it looks fine. 'Cause I thought I would give it to her and take it back, and I thought, you know what, Sue, it looks fine.
Never even know. It doesn't look like a garment that would need blocking to me.
I did block the other one. It does a little something for it, but not a lot. So I thought, you know what? I literally ran to Joann Fabrics last night, which, by the way, they have the most gorgeous buttons. I didn't end up using these, but I had bought these. They were a little too big, a little too big, but they had monsters.
Are you serious?
I am going to make one, a sweater for Camden, and get those monster buttons. And they're all different. They're so cute. So cute. So I don't know, for you guys with Joann Fabric around, holy cow, this dress it up. So it's www.dressup.com. If you don't have one, go on their website, check them out. I think I was like, I wanted to buy them all.
The monsters are like my heart is dancing right now because I monster like you know my button thing like I
Yeah. Oh, you would have died. I will get you a package next time I go, just to have. But I ended up with these simple, you can barely see them, but I think they're super pretty.
they're perfect.
Yeah, they're small. This is a very narrow button band. It's only like five rows. I love it. I love it. I love it. I'm super excited to give it to her. I just love giving hand knit gifts. Having said that, no, I'm not making Christmas gifts. Don't ask.
I am her trainer. I feel like I'm like coaching you for the big
I
game.
want to so bad.
No time.
Okay, I have a half finished object.
Good.
I finished my monkey sock by Cookie A. I do the original with the pearls, with Molly's yarn that I love so much, called Half Blood Prince, that I made my Madewell out of, which I'm living in, which is probably the sweater you're going to see me in at Rhinebeck, because it's going to be warm.
Is it?
Warm 60s to me is warm. 60s is light sweater weather. And of course, the cream vest.
I mean, that's just a given.
I hope you know where yours is.
I do, and I'm bringing it. We'll be twins.
We will. So you'll be see two people walking with cream vests, and you'll be like, oh. Oh. So anyways, I have this, and I started the cuff. Have you ever had that time when you're casting on a sock and it takes you four tries?
Yes.
This one.
Was happening?
Well, I had a cast on. I was doing a video chat with a couple people, had it all cast on, was ribbing away. Well, I did knit two, purl two. It's a knit one, purl one through the back loop, which I love. Ripped that out, cast it on again, started knitting, had one too many stitches, I realized four rows in, ripped that out, started it again.
Keep going.
I couldn't. It was driving me crazy. Because I almost just decreased and I was like, nope, it's going to drive me crazy. I know my limits of what I can do and what I can't do. And I was like, nope, I know it's going to bug me. Woke up this morning, cast it on like I was a pro, knit like I was a pro. I have never had that. I mean, I have had that, but not in a very long time.
Yeah, sometimes it's just the rhythm isn't there.
It isn't, and my concentration must be off, but I'm going to work on this in the car. I'm super excited. We have probably about a half hour drive to go to the christening. Both ways, so I'm already to the pattern, so I'm going to work on this.
I love it. I love so that sock, like the sock that you showed, it has her, because that's her cashmere, like her MCN, right?
Yes.
It has the most gorgeous halo around it. It looks so soft. Like I know it's soft because I felt it before, but like you, it even
It
looks.
is. Well, and you know what Dad said? This is shocking. He said, you're making a pair of socks to match your sweater. He was like, that's the same yarn as your sweater.
We're creeping in on him.
Where's he from?
It's
I was like, yep, that's it.
That's awesome.
I love it. I love it. I love making socks. I'm obsessed with sweater making, but it's balancing off with dying to cast on socks. Mm-hmm. Still no shawl action here.
That's okay. Ride that out. Ride it out.
I'm going to, because Kristen was showing her exploration station.
Oh my God. Her exploration station is
phenomenal. Gorgeous. But I have one cast on that I love, and I love everything about it. It screams me. But I'm on the brioche section, and I don't know how to brioche, even though I made a whole brioche shawl. I have no idea how to do it anymore.
You know what? I feel like what you should do is, and I need to do the same thing because we're in the exact same spot. I think we just need a day where, like, that is what we do because it's only one section.
Well, and once I watch the videos and do it a couple times, it's going to come right back. But if someone said to me, how do you brioche? I'm like, I have no idea. Yet I have the most beautiful brioche shawl that I made. Mm-hmm. Anyways, yeah. So, yeah, my shawl get up and go is gone.
Yeah.
It's gone for, and I'm okay with it because I have a lot of shawls.
Well, and it's allowing you to knit sweaters, like, and not feel like you should be knitting other things. Like, that's a good feeling.
It is. And I have to say, it's not distracting me, which I love. Like, I love that I'm okay with that because let's just say I finished one sweater and the other is 97% done.
Are you going to show that today? Or is it not any different than last time?
Well, it's not any different, but it's blocking. So my stone cutter. So, I'm going to forget the name of the podcast. Darn it. Can't remember. Sarah Dorky Emu.
Okay.
Okay. She's on my Periscope every day, or quite often. And Sarah finished her stone cutter, and she has it on her body in her, I think she just put up a new episode today, so her second to the last one. Dorky Emu, really super cute, loved it, forgot that she even did a podcast, asked her the other day, and I'm like, boy, that sounds familiar. I had started watching it a while ago, and I have so many, I forget what I'm watching, even though I'm subscribed, it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
But she's wearing hers in the second to the last episode, I'm pretty sure. It's gorgeous, and she can't stop talking about it. It's like we are one and the same, like, I loved knitting it. I'm casting another one on. It's the most beautiful sweater. She couldn't stop talking about it.
Gosh.
She's a prolific knitter. Holy crap. It's like, so anyways, I have, look at me. I'm all tangled. I have the back and the front upstairs blocking. I have one sleeve done. And then I have this sleeve, which is to the cap. So I have to start the decreases. So it will be done in no time.
So for sweaters that you seam, sorry, I don't mean to interrupt.
I'm done.
Do you always block them by piece? And then do you block them again once you seam them? Like what is that process like?
I'm copying Sarah.
Oh.
Typically I block after I seam, but it's kind of hard to do with such a big bulky sweater. Jared Flood. Sorry. Backtrack. Michelle Wang, who designed it. I was thinking Brooklyn Tweed. I believe she says to block the pieces. I don't know because I only read instructions to the point that I need them and then I put them away, which is ridiculous. She also says to seam the sleeves before you inset them. I don't think I can do that. I don't even think I'm capable of that. So we'll see. So I think you seam the sleeves and then set them in. Where typically I seam the back and the front and they lay flat and then I put the sleeve in.
Yep.
I don't know, but it's a cap sleeve. I'm dreading it. It's not my favorite.
What's a cap sleeve?
This is a cap sleeve where it goes. That's what I call it at least. See how it goes up and this is like, so it's not straight across where you lay it straight. Like,
yep.
Yeah, actually I have to fold it in half in order to put it in. Yeah, I'm not the end-all be-all finisher. I'm really not. I make it work. I can do it, but I'm not super good at it. And then Sarah did an I-cord bind-off on the neck, which is very shallow, and I am going to copy her on that. I have to look it up because I can never remember how to do it.
I'm going to have to go and watch that because I'm dying to see it on somebody.
Oh, you're going to die. It's the same color that Kristen did hers of Vull & Vine.
Kristen,
Kristen made one. She'll have it on at Rhinebeck if it's chilly, it sounds like. Listen to me. I'm pretty sure that's what she's going to wear.
Well, I'm like following her sewing.
Her sewing.
She is incredible.
Yeah. Her sewing, Gabby's sewing, Once Upon a Corgi. I'm so inspired by them. Jenny, Tiny Paper Foxes. I'm so inspired. And I honestly, I think over the holidays, because there will be a little downtime over the holidays, I'm going to start with a pair of pajama pants.
Okay.
And that's what I'm going to start with, because I don't even know how to cut out a pattern. I don't know how to do any of it.
Either.
And I want to be a sewer. In my dream world, I was going to sew a skirt for Rhinebeck and get really cute leggings and a really cute, like, my featherweight. And I was going to look adorable. It's not happening because I'm not capable of it. What's that?
You can purchase those things if you still wanted to.
I know. I want to make them, though. You know me. If I can make it, I don't want to buy it. I'm so drawn to go sit at Joann Fabrics at the pattern books and start looking through them, or going online, because there's some that people talk about all the time. I'm going to start watching some sewing podcasts. I want to sew.
Me too.
Machines hate me.
Yeah, machines aren't really my friends.
Yeah, they're not my friend. We'll see. I would love to think I could. I know I can. And there's very few things that I say I can't do that, but sewing's pretty overwhelming for me. I may call little Miss Gabby and say, please come over and help me learn how to sew.
I'm so glad I was closer, because I would come and spend the day with you guys.
I know. And she's a really great sewer too. She's an adventurous sewer. She sews beautiful. What she's been sewing for Rhinebeck is gorgeous. So we may have a sewing date. I just have to slow down a little. The business end is just, this is not the time to be putting new stuff in my brain. And I'm happy about that. But yeah, anyways, I don't know how we got on that tangent, but I want to be a sewer too.
I think we were talking about
Kristen. We started with Kristen has one of these. Yeah. Yeah. So I'm so excited about this, because when this is done, I'm going to cast on another sweater for myself and work on yours at the same time.
You know what sweater you're casting on for yourself?
I honestly think it's another Madewell with sweater weather, because I'm dying to make another Madewell. Isn't that weird? The two sweaters I've made, I'm on a second for both. That's how I love the patterns. I have another sweater that is quite a bit is done in that cupboard over there that I will pull out for our next podcast that I want to finish. Because it's gorgeous. And I don't even know the name of it. I hope I know where the pattern is. It's one of those. I was knitting like crazy and I stopped. It's gorgeous. Now I'm making myself curious. The ribbing is really unusual. You're going to die.
I want to see it.
I know. I'll dig it out.
Okay. Later.
Okay, go ahead. I'm sorry.
No, you don't have to apologize. The next thing I'm working on, so I had a big dilemma last week and I kind of talked through it with you and I got some great responses in the YouTube comments, kind of giving me feedback on what our watchers would do. So I had a lot of good information to kind of mull over. And what I ended up doing is...
Oh, it's so pretty.
No, I can't remember if... I think a lot of people have said this, like... Just go down and just use the Mexican hot chocolate for the rest of it.
Yeah, it's perfect.
Yep. So these are my last two stripes that I'll need to do. I'm on the very last pattern repeat. Like, I already did the very last fan and feather. Now I have two more rows of garter. And then I think I start the edging. I haven't really read the instructions for the next section.
Now, do you have enough of the other color that you could finish it with all of that? Like everything you just talked about with that color? Are you considering that, or are you going to stick to the hot chocolate?
Oh, wait. Oh, no. I don't have. I literally.
Oh, good call. You did it perfect. Perfect, perfect.
And I love it. Yeah, I really like the balance. Like, I'm really looking forward to seeing a much thicker portion. Like, part of me is even debating doing the larger size and just like trying to finish this off because I love this so much and I don't want to have an amount of it where like I'll never do anything with it. You know, like I want just enough for a square and I want it to be in this shawl.
I think you do need to go heavier with that color. Like you need to end it with a heavy amount of that for the, just for, I'm such a symmetrical balanced person when it comes to design. You definitely need like double what that one is, at least. Although I would say if you have extra, throw it over to me and I'll make you a pair of fingerless mitts to go with it.
Oh, that's true. So maybe I'll have to look and see how much extra yarn it would take. But yeah, I love it. I love the contrast, like everything about
it's it. Gorgeous. Thank
you. Yeah. I can't wait to really see like the fan and feather pattern, like blocking, I think is going to do wonders.
Yes, I agree. I love it.
It's so much fun. So yeah, that's my work in progress. And I'll actually probably start knitting on it now that I've shown it. I'm knitting.
Oh, love it.
Knitter's Pride interchangeables, size 4s.
Perfect. Love the color on those.
On these?
Yeah. The pink is gorgeous.
So fun. I love the marbles. They're so fun to me.
Yeah. You do really, really love them. I think you found the perfect needle for yourself.
At least for shawl knitting. Like, it's really my go-to for shawl knitting.
I agree. Do you have anything else for knitting?
I have one more work in progress that I cast on yesterday.
Go for it.
Want to do that? Okay.
More. I've been so like focused because I've had to finish things.
Oh, I know. Well, the baby sweater, I feel like.
I think that was the main part of the week.
Yeah.
That colorway. Oh my gosh.
I die over it. It's in a ball. I've had it wound up for so long because I had a million different ideas of what I was going to do with it and none of them ended up panning out. So this is Nice and Knit DK in their dockside colorway, I believe.
I want a sweater made out of that.
Oh, me too. Like, I love it so much. And, like, so the pattern I'm making is Candace just made one and Laura just made one. The Fleece and Sea Hat, I believe is how you say it.
Don't know.
But, so, like you, when you were talking about casting on your socks and doing a knit two, purl two instead of a knit one, purl one, I'm pretty sure it's supposed to be a knit one, purl one all the way around, but I just cast.
Isn't that what it is?
No.
Okay. It looks like knit. It looks like you knit one, purl two. Oh, no, I can see it now. I can see it. I couldn't see it. That was really weird.
Well,
it was like an optical illusion.
Yeah. So these are, this is knit through the back loop, purl through the back loop. So it pops a little bit more. So it is a little more challenging to. Like you can kind of see there.
You know what, though? That yarn and that color has such beautiful stitch definition. And that working through the back loop is really contributing to that. It's gorgeous.
Thank you. So you have to do 30 something rounds of the ribbing. So I still have a while to go. I think I'll work on this today. But I just caught the hat bug. And that hat, if you haven't seen it finished, go buy the pattern because it's amazing. Or go to, I know Candace took a picture of it on her Instagram. I think Laura might have, I can't remember though.
I'm so drawing a blank because I feel like I'm caught up on all of their podcasts and I'm not remembering that at all. But you know, the problem is I don't look at podcasts as much lately because I'll be like working around.
Candace's was a natural color and then the pom-pom was a turquoise. I don't know if that will jog your memory at all, but
maybe I've seen her latest one and I thought I had, maybe not.
No. But anyway, these are size 5 needles and the pattern calls for a 4, but I only had 5. So I was like, whatever. And they're Chow Goose with the red cord. And
how are they for that small? Because their cord, I love Chow Goose. But they tend to be a little stiffer, and it's working well for that small. That's good.
Great. The only way I can do these needles is if I'm using the entire loop, like magic loop. I still have a pair of socks that I refuse to finish because the cord is just driving me bananas.
Because it's too stiff for magic loop. Yeah. I have some somewhere. They must be in one of my project bags, though, because I haven't seen them in a while. That's gorgeous.
Thank you. Yeah, I love it. And you can really see, like, look at how tonal it is. Like these light sections.
Yeah.
It makes it really fun to knit on, just like because you can start to see where the tonal aspects come in.
It's gorgeous.
Thanks. I can't wait to have it. I love hats too much, I think.
You know what, you got to stop showing hats because I'm like thinking I could make those for Christmas gifts really, really fast.
No. Because you could only making one, but you would have to make like,
Eight
yeah.
or nine. I don't even know. All right, so we're back. Let's talk acquisitions because I got some.
Show me.
Which is so funny because we're not big acquisition people, but this is huge. And we are going to Rhinebeck, so we will have lots of acquisitions. I can't even fit this all in one hand. Hold on.
Oh my God, that is beautiful.
Knitpicks Felici. It was on sale.
Lychee.
I couldn't be, and I swear they sent me more because we talked about this earlier. Honestly, I don't think I would have ordered that. It's not my colors at all. Nothing in here would say I would order it. And then this one, there's a lot of other colors in here, so I do think I did, like with the lime green. These two are my favorites.
They're gorgeous. I love the one on the. Oh, actually, I'm with you. I don't know which one I like more.
Well, and then I'm mad. I wish I had ordered some solids for heels, tufts, and toes. Heels, cuffs, and toes.
Yes.
I might just go get some. I might even have some. I gotta look around, like a solid gray for this one, a cream for this one. I might have an orange for this one. I'm pretty sure I do have an orange.
Just dye them.
True. True. Anyways, I love them. Did you get any acquisitions?
No.
Because I got a gift that came yesterday. It's super cool. So remember last week when we were talking sock blanks and how I wanted Andy to do one with John Deere tractors, which was so bizarre that I even wanted one of those. And so then I got this note, which was hysterical. And she talked about it in her note. Like she was like, "I need your address right now." So this person, she goes, "There's just something in the podcast. I have to send you something right now." So I sent her my address, and look what came in the mail.
Oh my gosh.
It's a John Deere drawstring, which I'm all about lately, is the drawstring.
Yeah.
It's so funny. I watched the trends when we first started realizing there were project bags in the world. I feel like they were all drawstring, and then they all went to zipper, and now people are going back to drawstring.
Yeah.
I love this.
That is.
So it's from Sue. Hold on. And she is going to open an Etsy shop, she said, and it's going to be called Sue's, Sus with a two dots over the U. What is that called?
I have no.
I don't. Yeah. Anyways, it's coming soon, so be aware. But how thoughtful, she said. I didn't mean to appear like a crazy woman, but when you said that, I thought I have to send you this. So thank you, thank you, thank you. So sweet of you. I love it. Love it, love it. And you know, Grandpa was a John Deere guy, and it's just, he would have loved this. Not that he would have known what it was for, but that's okay. Thank you. I love it. I love it. I love it. I can't wait to put a project in it.
Did you say she has an Etsy store or she's going to have an Etsy store?
She's in the process of opening one. Hold on. Her business name will, she's getting all her inventory made, and her business name will be Sue's, Sus.
Well, I'll put it on the.
Yeah, that's what her dad called her, which again, it's very, we had a lot of similarities.
Yeah.
It was kind of odd, but very cool. And the fact that it's a John Deere is super cool. So those are the things I got this week in the mail.
I love that. I did realize that I haven't shown something, so I wanted to show Justin's progress on his newest pair of socks that he cast on. So keeps his in his Eternity Ranch. I gave this to him because I thought it was just so appropriate, and I'll borrow it if I need it, but we have this thing everywhere.
It's so him.
Yeah, we had it at, we went to Manhattan's for pizza and a beer last night with our friend, and it came with us there, and yeah, anyway. Oh, where were we? Oh my gosh, so we went to the St. John's Club, which is kind of like a private club, but not really, and it's open to the public on Fridays, and you're right on the water, and you can sit there and watch the sun go down. So we went with a bunch of friends and we did that, and he brought his knitting. And so he was just sitting there like talking knitting, and all of these, how many women would you say were around you?
Four or five, maybe.
There were like four or five, maybe even six women. And one of them was like, wait a minute, are you knitting? And they melted. They literally like, that is like, you could just see they melted.
We're not going to let him knit in public anymore.
It's his thing now. He knows.
I know. It is so funny. And you have a whole contingency going on up there right now with knitters. It's impressive. Those are gorgeous. What is that yarn?
This is, do you want to come talk about it?
No, you can.
He's the worst.
Fiber Stash in the...
It's gorgeous.
I would say,
how many pairs does he have now?
Robert Crawley color. Robert? And the Robert
Crawley. Of course.
Yeah.
Oh, they are gorgeous. And they're nubby because it's a tweed, right?
Yep.
Jesse, you're such a good knitter.
Thank you. Had great teachers.
Yes. Now tell me this. Now that Justin is a more experienced knitter and you guys are teaching knitting to a lot of people, Justin, are you helping them?
When I can. I still have a lot of, I guess, issues with seeing problems and trying to help, but yeah.
Not really though. You're really good. Like, no, it's honestly, when you're teaching somebody that's new and they're just knitting and purling, all you need to know is what a knit looks like and what a purl looks like.
Yeah. Well, and quite often when you don't think you're up to par with skills, like you think, oh, I don't really know how to do it as well as I think I am, you realize because you're able to help other people and then it hits you. Like, that's what I've experienced. Like, wow, I do know what I'm doing.
Yeah.
You know, so I do think it's good to be able to help other people because it boosts your skills tremendously. I mean, I'm sure you even feel that way.
Definitely. 100%.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, it helps with your confidence too. Like when I come across a problem now, I'm like one that I wouldn't typically be comfortable fixing, I'm like, I could do that. If somebody handed it to me and asked me to fix it, I could do it. So,
well, and when you live with people that are always helping you or fixing it for you, it's like you're not forced to use those skills. Where when you're teaching someone, you're forced to use those skills and you realize you have skills that you didn't know you had. So you're going to see your skills upping even more.
Even more, Jesse.
Yeah. Yep.
Phew.
So yeah.
All right.
I just wanted to show that because I love the colorway and the yarn. And I thought maybe Justin would make an appearance, but apparently not.
No, he's going to be like, who is the guy on Home Improvement that was behind the fence all the time?
Wilson.
Wilson. He's going to be our Wilson. Just a voice. All right, so we've got to start wrapping it up because I'm going to have to start getting going. So we have super exciting shop news.
Yes. Do you want to start? You talk about it.
Okay. Is there anything else we want to talk about, though? We did our thank yous for the update. That was huge.
Yep.
I think that was it. Okay, so.
Our last piece. Okay, so we should say if people aren't interested in shop news, that'll be all we talk about from here on in.
From here on in. And it won't be long, but yes, absolutely, if you're not interested. We actually have two really exciting shop things coming up. One is a collaboration that we're doing with, I think we can say, Carrie of the Freckled Whimsy asked us if we would like to do a collaboration with her. And of course, we jumped at it because we love Carrie of Freckled Whimsy. So I believe the release date for that is going to be November 5th, and we will start posting pictures once we have them, but she is making a beautiful bag, and I am making a coordinating yarn to go with it, and it's winter themed more than Christmas themed. It can go either way. It can go either way.
I would definitely say winter themed. Definitely.
Yes, and the colors are a little unique, which I'm super excited about. So that will be coming up in November, and then we are taking on an adventure called the 25 Skeins of Christmas Club. And I am so beyond excited about this. So beyond excited. It is going to be limited. We are going to put up 50 slots. Actually, let's talk about that later. I'll just tell you what the club is, and then we'll tell you how it's going to show up. It is going to be 24 mini skeins, one for every day leading up to Christmas, packaged in a way that it can be hung from your tree as an ornament.
Or anything that you like to decorate during the holidays. It doesn't have to be a tree necessarily.
Absolutely. You're right about that. There's a million things. Or put in a beautiful basket. Or there's so many things you could do with it. And each time, what I'm going to include in that is also a pattern to make a mini sock ornament. It's not to say that that's what you have to make. It's actually just a mini sock. It's not to say you have to make it. It's just an idea. And so as you remove, if you choose to use them as ornaments on a tree, as you remove them each day, you can knit up your little sock, which probably takes a couple hours. Depending on your speed and time and all of that. And you can replace it with that. So it's not like you'll have a bare spot on your tree, you're replacing it. Or you could do a little mitten or a little sweater or whatever you want. Or you could do nothing. But we like the thought of being able to replace what you've taken off your tree or out of your basket or whatever. So you will get 24 of them leading up to Christmas Day. And on Christmas Day, you will get a full skein. It will only be for these club members. It will never be reproduced. So it will be very exclusive, that part. The 24 won't be, because that's pretty impossible, because there are going to be so many different. But there will be some tonals, there will be some variegated, there will be on stellina base, they will be on steel toe base.
It'll kind of be a mixed bag, basically, is what we're saying.
Yes. So we're super excited about it. So at this, I'll hand it over to you so you can tell them about how we will put it up on Etsy and all of that.
Okay. And I also wanted to say, we're not going to be sending them, we're sending them to you as a package. So when we on Christmas Day, you get the full skein. You're going to get them all at once. And then it's just the way that we are going to number them. They'll all be numbered so that you'll know which one goes in which on which day. The number 25 will be the big skein.
Yes.
Hopefully that wasn't too confusing.
That makes more sense.
Okay. So yeah, you'll get it as a big gift. What we're going to be doing is we're going to be listing 50 slots. So it'll be a pre-order. Right?
Yes.
So on Wednesday, October 12th, we're going to be listing 50 slots for this club, and it's first come, first serve, and there'll be a full description there. So if you want a little more clarification, because sometimes when we talk about what we're doing, it doesn't come off as, like, I know for me, like, it's very hard to vocalize.
Yes, and to process it at the same time. Yes. So you will have a beautiful description over there. Definitely will all come in one package. Obviously, I want to have them all to you by December 1st. So they will probably leave here at the latest. Probably the third week in November would be my goal to get them all out. That's why we're promoting it so early. You kind of have to in order to get all the work done. Unfortunately, I'm probably not physically capable of doing more than 50. So I was going to start out with a lower number and make my way up to 50. And it's like, nope, let's just put up 50 slots and go from there. And I cannot wait to start dying. It's going to be such a fun way to die, because it's going to be a lot of playing, and
yeah,
I'm super excited about it. And the other thing that I think that I might do with them is I might have them on a clothesline or some sort of garland, And then each time I make one, I would add, you know, I would replace it, and that would be super fun. So yeah, but obviously you can do whatever. You can put them in your cozy memory blankets. They are the larger mini skeins, which I love.
20 grams.
20 grams, yep. So yeah, that's it. Super exciting.
Yep.
So yep, they will be there. It'll just be sitting there waiting for you guys.
Yes, and I don't know if I said what time. 7 p.m.
7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Eastern Standard Time on October 12th.
I am so excited.
I'm excited to see pictures of people. I'm curious to see what people will do with them.
Me too, because there's so many options. And because they're bigger, you might be able to do more than one thing with them.
Yeah, for sure.
You could do a littler sock and then part of your cozy memory or anything. It's so exciting.
So, yeah.
That's probably our last big adventure for the year. And it's been busy, crazy, exciting. But with holidays coming, I always like to have a little more downtime. And so that will allow it. And it's so exciting.
Yeah.
And then we will start off the new year with a bang, because we already have thoughts in mind for that. So, which I'm really excited about.
Yeah. Lots in the works.
Lots. So last thing we have to talk about is Rhinebeck.
So yes, we are going to Rhinebeck this upcoming weekend, which is so exciting. I ended up, we had a change of plans. So I'm going to end up being there, which is really, really cool. I can't wait.
I'm so excited.
It's going to be great. So we are going to be there. So if you see us and you want to say hi, please do. Please do. And feel comfortable. We're pretty, I think, approachable and
yeah,
want to meet you guys. Yeah. Yeah.
I'm definitely looking forward to meeting so many people, like even my Periscope people. But keep in mind, we have no idea what you look like because you only get to see us.
Yeah.
So help us out with, you know, honestly, I feel like we need to know like Ravelry names, or it's going to be weird. Like, I think that'll be my first question. Well, what's your Ravelry or Periscope name? Because then I'll have the connection. But I'm so thrilled you're coming. I was feeling like half.
Yeah.
Like it really did feel like my right arm was being cut off. So it's so exciting. We will be there together, cream vests and all.
We're both bringing them. I have one. I'm bringing it.
We're going to need it. It's going to be that kind of weather. And we will have with us our Legacy Fiber Arts buttons that we would love for you to have.
It's upside down.
Oh, and we would love for you to have our Legacy Fiber Arts buttons. So if we forget to give you one, because it'd be like, here, you want a button? So please ask us for a button. We would love to give you our button. We would love to see them on every bag. I think a lot of people are bringing buttons, and I'm hoping to get a lot.
Me too.
Because I'm going to buy one of those Fringe Supply bags. They're not going to be there, are they?
I don't know. I've never been.
I have, but it's been quite a while. So yeah, anyways, I really want buttons because I'd like to get one of those bags and put them on there.
Me too. Justin wants one too. I introduced him to Fringe. The other
Fringe is a great... Now, do they have them at Neato?
They do, but when we went the other day, they only had one left and it wasn't a color that Justin wanted. So, but they said they were going to be getting more in.
Oh man, I love that. I love everything about Fringe Supply. Oh, if they were there, I would die. Between their pads and they're super cool.
Yeah, they are.
I have a christening to go to. I've got to wrap the present. I'm so glad we fit this in today. You won't see us next week. Nope. I don't think.
Heck.
Yeah, we've got some really crazy busyness coming up. But who knows? People are like, will you Periscope from Rhinebeck? No guarantees. Just because I think the Wi-Fi or the cell signal there is kind of weak. Well, I'm thinking for Periscopes, who knows? We might do a little in the house that we can put on a podcast. We'll see. We'll see what works. And honestly, I'm looking at this as like a little mini vacation. So it's going to be hard to fit everything in. But if it fits in naturally, we will absolutely do it.
But no promises.
No promises.
Cool.
Sorry.
Cool, cool. All right. Well, we got to get going with our days. We got football to watch.
Oh, the Giants are on tonight.
I know. We're going to watch the path.
All right, guys. We got to go.
We got to go. We got stuff to do, and we love you all. Thank you for spending time with us.
Thank you.
Don't forget Wednesday on the Wednesday the 12th at 7 o'clock if you want to be a part of our 25, what did we call it?
25 Skeins of Christmas Club.
Yeah, if you want to be a part of that, that's the time. And the link is in our Instagram and whatever. We got to go. My brain is gone. Knitting.
Okay, needles up.
Needles up, guys. Have a great week.
All right, bye, guys. Thanks for being here.